हेलो वेलकम फ्रेंड्स इन ईपीजी पाठशाला. आई एम डॉक्टर अशोक शर्मा असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एंड रामलिंगा स्वामी फेलो डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बायोकेमिस्ट्री ऑल इंडिया इंस्टीट्यूट मेडिकल साइंसेज न्यू दिल्ली. इन दिस मॉड्यूल वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट जी प्रोटीन एंड इट्स रोल इन सिग्नलिंग मैकेनिज्म. एज वी नो दैट सेल सिग्नलिंग इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट प्रोसेस required for the normal growth and development of cells in a organism. A signal transduction is a cellular mechanism that converts a stimulus into a response in the cell. There are two stages in this process. One, a signaling molecules attach to a receptor protein into on the cell membrane, and second is a second messenger transmit the signal into the cell and a change take place inside the cell. These two mentioned basic process helps the cell to sustain through various environmental cues and develop tolerance against stress conditions. All cells rely on signal transduction to communicate extracellular information to the intracellular machinery by a chemical or physical signal which is transmitted through a cell as a series of molecular events. Generally, protein phosphorylation is catalyzed by protein kinases which ultimately result in a cellular response. Proteins responsible for detecting stimuli are generally called receptors. The basic cell signaling machinery involves a receptor molecules that receive the signals. The signal stimulus could be a hormone, odorant, antigen, neurotransmitter, light, or the surface of another cell, which transport signals into the cell via the membrane receptor through signal transduction triad. The target of the signal may be intracellular receptors, enzyme molecules, special transport vehicles, and finally transcription factors. All these signals ultimately control the gene expression. There are several signaling mechanisms present in the cell to carry out normal functions. One of the important signaling cascade is formed by GTP binding proteins, or simply known as G proteins, so called because of their ability to bind to guanine nucleotide. G protein signaling controls a multitude of diverse cellular functions, including responses to hormonal signals and environmental stimuli such as light and odor. One more molecule that is involved in this signaling cascade and form an important part of the cascade is G protein coupled receptor, or GPCR. In this module, we will study following objectives. What is G proteins, G protein structure and signaling mechanism, functions of G protein coupled receptors. First, we are going to discuss about G protein. G proteins are a regulatory protein that mediate a link between an information molecules bound to a membrane receptor. Example, a hormone, a neurotransmitter, and a cellular effectors, example an enzyme or membrane channels. It is located on the inside of the cytoplasmic membrane, where it is bound by lipid anchors, covalently bound fatty acid or isoprenoids. They drive the designation according to their ability to bind guanosine nucleotide, GTP or GDP. They are heterodimers associated with the inner surface of the plasma membrane and transmembrane receptors of hormones. These are called G protein coupled receptors or GPCRs. G proteins are described by Professor Alfred Goodman Gilman. He is an American pharmacologist and biochemist, and Professor Martin Rodwell, it is a molecular endocrinologist. Both were shared the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine in 1994 for the discovery of G protein and the role of these protein in signal transduction in cells. Nobel Prize have been awarded for many aspects of signaling by G proteins and G protein receptor molecules. These include receptor antagonist, neurotransmitters, neurotransmitter reuptake, G protein coupled receptors, G protein second messengers, the enzyme that triggers protein phosphorylation in response to cyclic AMP, and consequently metabolic process such as glycogenolysis. G protein coupled receptor GPCRs are consist of 7 transmembrane protein as shown in this figure, which bind signal molecules outside the cell, transduct the signal into the cell, and finally cause a cellular response. The GPCRs work with the help of a G protein which bind to the energy rich GTP. It is also known as heptahelical receptors or serpentine receptors and G protein linked receptors. These proteins make up transmembrane receptor whose purpose is to bind molecules on the outside of the cell and initiate the signal transduction pathway. The signal transduction pathways are the process by which a cell changes the form of one signal into the stimulus or a signal of another. These processes are carried out by enzymes. As the number of proteins and molecules increases, the size of the signal cascade increases rapidly, allowing for the large response to a relatively small initiation factor. G protein linked receptors are activated by ligands in the form of hormones, proteins, or other signaling molecules. This in turn lead to the activation of an intracellular G protein by way of a certain interaction with the receptor. The G proteins act like relay batons to pass message from circulating hormones into the cell and transmit the signal throughout the cell with the ultimate goal of amplifying the signal in order to produce a cell response. A hormone such as epinephrine encounters a receptor in the membrane of a cell, then a G protein is activated as it makes contact with the receptor to which the hormone is attached. Lastly, the G protein passes the message of a hormone to the cell by switching on a cell enzyme that triggers a response. In addition to signaling, they have other physiological roles like sense of smell. The olfactory epithelium receptors bind odorants and pheromones. They are also act as a mood regulators. The receptor in the brain bind neurotransmitter dopamine. They also regulate the immune system by dealing with inflammation and response of foreign bodies. Nervous system transmission, G proteins play very important role to control the blood pressure, heart rate, and digestive process, and they also help in sensing the cell density. Another example of G protein coupled receptor in the body has to do with the sense of taste. 5 different tastes have been recognized by science: sweet, salty, sour, bitter, and umami. Umami, the flavor of the meaty food, was the taste most recently added to the list, as it was identified by a Japanese scientist in 1908. GPCR taste receptors are found on our taste buds, and there are several different types. G protein coupled receptors are only found in eukaryotic cells and are found in a variety of sizes. There are two main pathways that the G protein follows. The first is the CMP pathway, cyclic AMP pathway, and the second is the phosphatidyl install signaling pathway. The cyclic AMP pathway has 5 players that aid in the signal transduction: a hormone that stimulates the receptor, a regulative G protein, adenyl cyclase, protein kinase A, and cyclic AMP, as shown in figure. The stimulative hormone is a receptor that binds with the stimulative signal molecules. The G proteins are linked to the stimulative hormone receptors, and its alpha subunit can stimulate activity. Adenyl cyclase is a transmembrane glycoprotein that catalyzes ATP to form cyclic AMP with the help of cofactor, usually magnesium or manganese ions. Protein kinase A is an enzyme used for cell metabolism. The cyclic AMP transfers the effect of hormone which are unable to pass directly through the cellular membrane. It also regulates the effect of adrenaline and glucagon, in addition to regulating the passage of calcium ion through ion channels. Cyclic AMP activates protein kinase A, which is usually an inactive tetramer. Cyclic AMP binds to the regulatory subunit of the kinase and causes the dissociation of the regulatory and catalytic subunits. This dissociation activates the catalytic unit and allows them to phosphorylate and substrate protein. The phosphatidyl install signaling pathway has the signal molecules bind with the G protein receptor. This activates the phospholipase C, which is located in the membrane. Lipase hydrolyzes phosphatidyl install into two messenger binded with the receptors in the membrane. This opens up as a calcium ion channel and activates protein kinase C, which causes the cascade of signals. Study has shown that GPCR consists of transcriptional, post-transcriptional, and post-translational mechanism, and recently it has been observed that by splicing the pre-mRNA regulate the GPCR activity by targeting GPCR secretin of the exon on a 14 amino acid sequence. Now we discuss about different types of G protein signaling. G protein can refer to distinct family of proteins: heterotrimeric G protein, and sometimes referred to as the large G proteins, are activated by G protein coupled receptor and are made up of alpha, beta, and gamma subunits. Second, small G protein, which is 20 to 25 kilodalton molecular weight, belong to the RAS superfamily of small GTPase. These proteins are homologous to alpha subunit found in heterotrimers, but are in fact monomeric, consisting of only a single unit. However, like their larger relative, they also bind GTP and GDP and are involved in signal transduction. Heterotrimeric G proteins, also called large G proteins, they are different types of heterotrimeric G proteins, share a common mechanism. They are activated in response to a conformational changes in the GPCR, exchanging GDP for GTP, and dissociating in order to activate other proteins in a particular signal transduction pathway. The specific mechanisms, however, differ between protein types. Receptor activated G proteins are bound to the inner surface of the cell membrane. They are consist of G alpha and the tightly associated G beta gamma subunit. There are many class of G alpha subunits. GS alpha, S stand for stimulatory. GI alpha, I stand for G inhibitory. GO alpha, O stand for others. GQ/11 alpha and G12/13 alpha are some examples. They behave differently in the recognition of the effector molecules but share a similar mechanism of activation. As shown in figure A, heterotrimeric G protein are composed of three distinct subunits, alpha, beta and gamma. Receptor activation causes the binding of the G protein and the alpha subunit to exchange GDP for GTP, leading to a dissociation of the alpha and beta gamma subunits. The biological action of these G proteins are terminated by hydrolysis of GTP, which is enhanced by GTPase activating proteins. Now, please see in figure B. Monomeric G proteins use similar mechanism to relay signals from activated cell surface receptor to intracellular target. Binding of GTP stimulates the biological actions of these G proteins and their activity is terminated by hydrolysis of GTP, which is also regulated by gap proteins. Small G proteins are monomeric G proteins and also comes under the GTP binding G proteins. These monomeric GTPases also relay signals from activated cell surface receptor to intracellular targets, which include the cytoskeleton and the vesicle trafficking apparatus of the cell. The first small G protein was discovered in a virus that caused rat sarcoma tumors and become consequently referred to as RAS. RAS is a molecule that enables regulate cell differentiation and proliferation by means of relaying signal from receptor kinases to the nucleus. The viral form of RAS is defective, which accounts for the potential of the virus to cause the uncontrolled cell proliferation that results in tumor. Considering then a huge range of small GTPases were identified and can be sorted into five unique subfamilies with different functions. As an instance, a few are concerned in vesicle trafficking inside the presynaptic terminal or elsewhere in the neuron, at the same time as others play a vital role in protein and RNA trafficking inside and outside of the nucleus. Termination of signaling by means of both heterotrimeric and monomeric G protein is decided by hydrolysis of GTP into GDP. The rate of GTP hydrolysis is essential property of particular G protein that may be regulated by different proteins, termed GTPase activating G proteins. By replacing GTP with GDP, gaps return G protein to their inactive forms. So gaps were first identified as regulator of small G proteins. G proteins, but recently similar proteins were found to regulate the alpha subunits of heterotrimeric G proteins. Therefore, monomeric and trimeric G proteins characteristics as molecular timers that is active in their GTP bound state and become inactive once they have hydrolyzed the bound GTP into GDP. Inside the cell, on the plasma membrane, G protein bind GDP when inactive and GTP when active. When the GPCRs bind to signal molecule, the receptor is activated and changes the shape, thereby allowing it to bind to an inactive G protein. When this occurs, GTP displaces the GDP, which activates the G protein. The newly activated G protein then migrates along the cell membrane until it binds to an enzyme and changes the enzyme shape and conformation. This change in the enzyme structure leads to the next step in the pathway and generates a cellular response. After transduction, G protein functions as a GTPase and hydrolyzes the bound GTP, which causes a phosphate group to fall off. This regenerates GDP and inactivates the G protein, and the cycle repeats. Activated G protein modified the function of many downstream effectors. Most of those effectors are enzymes that produce intracellular second messengers. Effector enzymes encompass adenyl cyclase, guanylyl cyclase, phospholipase C, and others. The second messengers produced by those enzymes trigger the complex biochemical signaling cascades as shown in this figure. Due to the fact each of these cascades is activated by specific G protein subunit, the pathways activated via a particular receptor are determined with the aid of specific identity of the G protein subunits associated with it. As well as activating effector molecules, G protein can also directly bind to and prompt ion channels. For example, a few neurons as well as heart muscles cells have G protein coupled receptor that bind acetylcholine. Because these receptors are also activated through the agonist muscarine, they are commonly referred to as a muscarinic receptors. Activation of muscarinic receptors can open potassium channel, thereby inhibiting the rate at which the neuron fires action potential or slowing the heartbeat of the muscle cell. These inhibitory responses are believed to be the result of beta-gamma subunits of G protein binding to the potassium channel. The activation of the alpha subunits can also cause the rapid closing of voltage-gated calcium ion and sodium ion channels. Due to the fact these channels bring inward currents involved in producing action potentials, closing them make it more difficult for target cell to fire. Now, we discuss the physiological role of G proteins. In addition to signaling, they play very important role in physiological function like sense of smell. The olfactory epithelium receptor bind odorant and pheromones. They also play very crucial role in and act as a mood regulator. The receptor present in the brain bind neurotransmitter, example dopamine. They also play role in immune system regulation by dealing with the inflammation and response to foreign bodies. In nervous system transmission, they regulate the blood pressure, heart rate and digestive process. Another example of G protein coupled receptor GPCRs in the body has to do with the sense of taste. 5 different tastes have been recognized as we discussed in previous slide: sweet, salty, sour, butter and umami. Umami is the flavor of meaty food, was the taste most recently added in the list. GPCR taste receptors are found on our taste buds, and there are several different types. G protein coupled receptors follow two main pathways, cyclic AMP pathway and phosphatidyl indole signaling pathway. The cyclic AMP pathway has five players that add in the signal transduction, a hormone that stimulates the receptors, a regulative G protein, adenylyl cyclase, protein kinase A, and cyclic AMP. The stimulative hormone is a receptor that binds with the stimulative signal molecules. The G proteins are linked to the stimulative hormone receptor, and its alpha subunit can stimulate activity. Adenylyl cyclase is a transmembrane glycoprotein that catalyze ATP to form cyclic AMP with the help of a cofactor, usually magnesium and manganese ion, as we discussed in previous slide. Protein kinase A is an enzyme used for cell metabolism. The cyclic AMP transfers the effects of hormone which are unable to pass directly through the cellular membrane. It also regulates the effects of adrenaline and glucagon in addition to regulating the passage of calcium ions through the ion channel. Finally, cyclic AMP activates PK protein kinase A, which is usually an inactive tetramer. Cyclic AMP to the regulatory subunit of the kinase and cause the dissociation of the regulatory and catalytic subunit. This dissociation activates the catalytic units and allow them to phosphorylate the substrate proteins. Now, we discuss about phosphatidyl indole signal pathway. In this pathway, signal pathway has the signal molecules bind with the G protein receptor. This activates the phospholipase C, which is located in the membrane. Lipase hydrolyzes the phosphatidyl indole into two messengers, binded with the receptor in the membrane. This opens up a calcium ion channel and activate protein kinase C, which cause the cascade of signals. Now, we discuss the function of G protein coupled receptors. Discovery about G protein switches and its structure, which is made of three subunits, alpha, beta and gamma, will help us to understand how we can inhibit the transmission or increase with some other ligands. G protein coupled receptors are transmembrane receptor proteins that, when activated by ligands like hormones, proteins or other signaling molecules, they lead to the activation of an intracellular G protein through a specific interaction with the receptor. The G protein in turn transmits the signal to other proteins within the cell to ultimately amplify the signal and produce a cellular response. Understanding the structure and dynamics of the receptor could clarify the specific interaction of the receptor makes with the ligand on the outside and G protein on the intracellular side, thereby leading to the understanding of how the receptors work. Consequently, drugs, agonist or antagonist, can be designed to bind the receptor and control its response, whether it's to transmit the signal to the G protein or inhibit the transduction. Moreover, monitoring the effects of such signal can help in understanding the type of induced cellular responses and potentially uncover diseases that are proliferated in this manner. G protein coupled receptors are widespread in their use in the eyes. Opsonins, a GPCR, translates the electromagnetic radiations into the cellular signals, thus allowing visual perceptions. In the nose, olfactory epitheliums bind odorants and pheromones which allow for the sense of smell. However, there are problems associated with GPCR also. Many human diseases, including bacterial infection, involve the GPCRs, where bacteria produce toxin which interfere with the function of G proteins. Example of such diseases include cholera, whooping cough, botulism, etc. Let's see a closer view of how altered G protein affects cholera and whooping cough. When there is a beta subunit binding to a G alpha S ganglioside and a catalytic subunits entering the cell, then cholerogens, a toxin resulted from cholera, forms. The catalytic subunit alter the G alpha S ganglioside, in which alpha part of the protein is adjusted via attaching ADP ribose to arginine. As a result of this alteration, G alpha S ganglioside becomes stable, meaning that now G alpha S ganglioside is in its active form. The active G alpha S ganglioside then does its job to activate the protein kinase A, denoted by pKa. The chloride channel is nearby pKa, so the pKa enter, and thus there is no more absorption of sodium ions. This is saying that there is a huge loss of sodium chloride and water in the body, as seen in the symptoms of cholera. In treating cholera, the most effective way is to rehydrate the body using glucose electrolyte solution. Whooping cough, on the other hand, is different from the cholera, in which the ADP ribose moiety is added by the toxins. In this case, calcium ion channel is closed, whereas the potassium channel is opened by G alpha S ganglioside. The result is that the G alpha S ganglioside is in its inactive form and ultimately ending up with uncontrolled cough. In addition, pharmacologists estimate that 60% of the medicine achieve their effect by acting on G protein pathways. Since G protein is a switch molecule which passes the message inward like a relay button, it can be turned on only when needed, then shut off. Some illness like cholera occur when G protein intentionally left on. Now, dear student, we summarize this module. As we understand in this module, G protein is a regulatory protein that mediates a link between an information molecules bound to a membrane receptor and a cellular effector. G proteins were discovered by Alfred G. Gilman and Martin Rowell and share the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine for elucidating the role of G protein in signal transduction in cells. G proteins are consist of two distinct family of that is heterotimeric G proteins, also called large G protein, and small G proteins, which is 20 to 25 kilodalton. Large G proteins are activated by G proteins coupled receptor and made of alpha, beta and gamma subunits, and small G proteins belong to the RAS superfamily of small GTPases. The binding of chemical signals to their receptors activates the cascades of signal transduction events in the cytosol of target cell. Within such cascades, G proteins serve as a pivotal role. Within such cascades, G protein play very crucial role because the molecular transducing elements that couple membrane receptors to their molecular effectors within the cell. The range of G proteins and their downstream targets lead to many types of physiological responses by directly regulating the gating of the ion channels. G proteins can impact the membrane ability of target cells. many human diseases, including bacterial infection involving the GPCRs, where bacterial produce toxins which interfere with the function of G proteins. Example of such diseases as we discuss like include cholera, whooping cough and botulism. Dear student, hope you understand these modules, and if any if you have any doubt and question, please contact us. Thank you very much.